So, because Captain America Civil War is soon released in the cinemas, I thought it would be a good time to make a video about Captain America and everybody who took the mantle of Captain America at least once and for a period of time. So, of course, I'm gonna mention Steve Rogers, the original Captain America, who was transformed with the super soldier serum into old Captain America. But now at the all different Marvel, the super soldier serum got sucked out of his body and now he's aged.
We go hide away in daylight. We go undercover, wait out the sun. Got a secret side in plain sight. Where the streets are empty, that's where we run.
So Jeffrey Mace was patriot before he became Captain America. It was at the similar time as William Nasland became Captain America. So you see, there were at the same period of time many Captain Americas, and he served also longer than Steve Rogers as Captain America. He served from 1946 to 1952. Sorry, from 1946 to 1952. But currently, he's the second longest serving cap, because we all know Steve Rogers returned. He was not long dead, and then he became Captain America again. So, just normal. After the time, he became patriot again, and for once, even Captain America before he died of cancer. So, William Burnside is actually the craziest and mental unstable, most mental unstable Captain Americas of all Captain Americas who had been. He was actually a fan of Captain America, and later changed his name legally into Steve Rogers, and even got under surgery to resemble completely Steve Rogers from the look. So it's pretty crazy, and he found actually a copy of the super soldier serum in Germany from another German doctor, and gave it to the American government under the condition that he becomes the new Captain America. So that's the reason why he did all the stuff with the surgery and changed his name into Steve Rogers. He changed even his vocals so he sounds like Steve Rogers. And yeah, but his dreams were squashed when the Korean War ended. It turned out that the serum was not an exact copy of it, so it made him a little bit crazier. He was later brainwashed to become the grand director, and did a lot of crazy stuff. And he fought even with the original, and finally got shot by the original Bucky Barnes to death. So no more William Burnside or Steve Rogers. So before John Walker became Captain America, he was a super patriot. No, how it sounds. But later, when he got actually to be Captain America, he got in touch with the power broker. And due to this process, he got similar powers as Captain America, but he's really a superhuman. They are really on a superhuman standard. So he has the same things like Captain America, but it's on a superhuman standard. But he was not really long Captain America, I think, just in the 80s, like that. So, and after his Captain America time, he became the US agent, as can here see his US agent costume, what is really similar to the to a Captain America costume. And he later lost in the Siege of Asgard. I think he lost his hand and his legs, so he had retired. But for one last time, he was active as US agent in Doctor Doom's Avengers in the Axis main event. So now we have the original Bucky of Captain America, also known as James Buchanan Barnes, also known as Winter Soldier. And after the Civil War event, spoilers, when Steve Rogers got killed for a briefly time, Bucky became the new Captain America. He had still his prosthetic arm, he had a similar shield, and he fought often with a pistol. It wasn't not a long time, but it was his time as Captain America. And he led even a version of the Avengers after Civil War. And he's coming, of course, in the next Captain America movie again, where he has a much bigger role than in Captain America: The Winter Soldier. So we see he really has evolution in the movies too. In the first movie, he's just a soldier. In the second movie, he has an assassin, and in our next movie he becomes more heroic again. So yeah. And also, Bucky Barnes is one a sidekick, but Marvel is not really known for sidekicks, so he's one of the few sidekicks in the Marvel universe. What is kind of cool, or not, how you see it. And now to the second Black Captain America. The first one was Isaiah Bradley, and the second one is Sam Wilson, also known as Falcon, the second sidekick of Steve Rogers. So yeah, he was long time Falcon, and it just happened recently in the all new, all different Marvel lineup, where he got the Captain America mantle. It was actually approved by Steve Rogers, who is old, like you all know, in the all new, all different Marvel universe. He's Steve Rogers is old, and he took over. So it's not Bucky's time; it's his time. That was just great. Like, they're not going to Bucky again; they're going to Sam Wilson, and I think he has really earned this to be Captain America. So yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. We'll see us next time.